Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in managerial accounting. And in this video, we're going to discuss the concept of present value. We'll start off with the definition of both present value and future value and discuss how these concepts are used to make business decisions. Next, we'll dive into a couple of specific examples to get a clear understanding of how the concept of present value works. Understanding this concept can help companies manage their finances more effectively and make smarter long-term decisions. So let's get started. My grandfather always used to tell me that when he was my age, he could go out for a full lunch and see a movie for only $1. Nowadays, you would spend significantly more than that, and it's like this in most areas of life. But why is this the case? The reason for this is that a dollar today is not the same as a dollar tomorrow. The purchasing power of money changes over time as a result of things like inflation and interest. Companies need to keep this in mind when making long-term decisions that impact their cash flows. Now, before we dive into present value, let's briefly discuss the idea of future value. As we know, money can earn interest over time. And future value takes into account the time value of money. It can help companies and investors with investment decisions by determining the potential value of an asset and the expected rate of return that they'll earn over time. Future value can be calculated as follows. Present value multiplied by 1 plus the interest rate to the power of the number of compounding periods. For example, let's say I invest $100 with a 7% interest rate for 2 years and want to determine what it's going to be worth at the end of the investment. The calculation would look like this. We would take the $100 present value times 1 plus the 7% interest rate to the power of 2 compounding periods. This would result in a future value of $114.49. In other words, the $100 investment is expected to be worth $114.49 in 2 years' time. Performing this calculation is a great tool that can aid in the investment decision process. Sometimes companies need to determine the amount to be invested today in order to produce a certain future value. This amount to be invested today is called the present value. This concept can also be extremely useful when a company knows their expected future cash flows from an investment and wants to discount these cash flows back to today's dollars in order to evaluate whether the investment makes sense today. When making these types of investment decisions, companies need to take into account a number of factors, such as the length of time of the investment, the projected net annual cash flows that they expect to earn over the time frame, the desired rate of return or discount rate, and the value they believe the asset will be worth at the end of the investment, or the salvage value. Now that we understand a little bit more about these concepts, let's talk about a common misconception. While future value and present value calculations provide very useful information, they don't always take into account the full picture. It's important to remember that these are just projections, and anytime we're projecting into the future, there's additional risks that arise. These projections don't take into account certain factors that could impact the future value, such as economic conditions, including excessive inflation, government regulation, and recessions. Any of these factors could significantly impact the purchasing power of money, so we must keep them in mind. However, with that said, these tools are still highly useful in evaluating investments. So let's take a look at an example of the present value calculation. What if an investor wanted to know how much was needed to be invested today in order to earn a certain return in the future? Well, let's use the present value calculation to answer this question. Remember, present value equals the future value divided by 1 plus the interest rate to the power of the number of years. Now, say for example, an investor wanted to know how much to invest today in order to earn $557 in 2 years from now based on an interest rate of 10%. This rate is also called the discount rate, since it's being used to discount the future cash flows to today's dollars. In this case, we would take the $557 future value and divide it by 1 plus the 10% interest rate to the power of 2 years. Here, the present value equals $460. This means in order to earn $557 over the next 2 years, based on these conditions, the investor would need to invest $460 today. When companies are making investment decisions, such as deciding whether to buy a new piece of equipment, they may need to calculate the present value of a series of future cash flows called an annuity. Sometimes these cash flows are uneven, as they'll differ each year. Now in this case, they would need to calculate the present value of each individual future cash flow and then add them together to get the total present value of the cash flows expected from this investment. By subtracting out the original investment from this total, we can determine the net present value of this investment. This is another useful tool that can be used to evaluate investment decisions. And that brings us to the end of this video. Now remember, in order for organizations to make successful long-term investment decisions, they need to consider the impact of the time value of money, and present value concepts allow them to do this effectively. If you're interested in learning more about this topic or others, please feel free to check out our additional videos on many more related topics.